Oliver Hermanus' rolprent Moffie het een reeks internationale toekennings gekry. Nou is dit ook by die plaaslike theaters in Suid-Afrika te sien. Hier by die Woordfees in Stellenbosch het hy 'n verskeidenheid besprekings daaroor gehou en ons is nou hier by die Drosdy Theater in Stellenbosch om met hom oor sy rolprent te gesels. Sugar man, won't you hurry? 'Cause I'm tired of these scenes. For a blue coin, won't you bring back all the colors of my dreams? Oliver, waar het die idee van hierdie fliek vandaan gekom? Hoekom het jy so sterk daaroor gevoel om hierdie fliek te maak?
The idea started with the book. I was offered the book and het die boek gelees. And once I'd read it, I was looking for something inside of it that I thought that would resonate with me personally. And that kind of became about this bit of history that I didn't know a lot about. And I decided that I would, when you make a movie, you know, you learn something. So I wanted to learn about that. So that's what stimulated me.
So in die 70er en 80er jare het ons baie rolprente gehad wat oor die grensoorlog gegaan het. En toe was daar bietjie van 'n stilte gewees en toe die laaste paar jaar het ons nou Verrekkie gehad en toe Canary en nou Moffie. Maar nog steeds is daar baie mense wat vir my vra hoekom Moffie so kort nadat Canary gemaak is en wat ook oor homoseksualiteit in die oorlog gaan.
I mean, yeah, we don't get together as filmmakers and suddenly decide we're all going to make a movie about the same thing. I think we have different audiences in mind. Moffie is a very expensive made film. You know, films like Canary are sort of, they're made by television companies. They're produced for a very small particular market. And Moffie's market is a totally different market. You know, we obviously want the film to be seen by as many South Africans as possible. But this is a film that has international ambitions. And so we don't ever see ourselves as being part of the same kind of business. But we were very aware of the making of Canary when it was being made because they shared their script with us and we knew they were going about it, but we were actually, Moffie took so long to make that we were making Moffie before they even started making Canary, and Canary even came out before we finished making Moffie because we spent so much time writing. But I don't personally see these films existing in the same market space.
So jy het nou net gepraat van jou hele skryfproses. Hoe het jy te werk gegaan in terme van die boek wat jy gelees het en toe om dit te verwerk, en hoe het jy besluit hoeveel van die boek en watter elemente van die boek gaan jy nog steeds in jou fliek gebruik?
As the director, you decide what you're taking out of the book. Like, what is it that the book is about for you? And for me, this book was about indoctrination and about the shameful nature of the army toward gay conscripts. And that's the theme that I run with. And every single scene that you write is about how you develop and explore that theme. So the book is an inspiration for us. We were never making an absolute adaptation. We knew that, and when we shared the script with the author, when we had finished it, he also felt that we had done something completely different, which he also liked. But there was never an attitude of us making a direct translation.
En jy skok nogal gehore, gewoonlik met jou rolprente, as ons nou dink aan Skoonheid en Shirley Adams. Is dit dat jy met jou rolprente mense wil wakker skrik, of wat is jou intensie met jou rolprente?
I mean, the films shock, I think, here in South Africa, they shock South Africans, because South Africans is a very conservative market who don't have a very, you know, large appetite for watching films that challenge them. You know, South Africans generally go to the movies to forget. They go to the movies to have an escapist, nostalgic experience, and I don't offer that experience. My films are far more interested in being provoking and making people kind of look at our society or our history. The intention as a filmmaker is just different.
En hoe besluit jy watter onderwerpe om aan te pak? Jy sê iemand het vir jou hierdie boek aangebied, maar hoe het jy geweet hierdie is die storie wat jy wil vertel?
Well, when you're developing a film, you're developing many films. You know, I was developing three other films at the same time as I was developing this one. And at the moment, I'm developing three or four films at the same time. Ultimately, one of them gets ahead of the pack. One of them develops faster, or the finance attaches. You choose a collection of projects to develop, and then one of them kind of sticks out, and that becomes the film that you make. But you're never making just that one movie for at least, you know, 1 or 2 years. You're exploring many different movies.
En binnen die rolprent zelf, wat er type thema's gebruik jy? Ek het bijvoorbeeld opgeleid dat jy baie water, swembad, see gebruik. Wat is die betekenis daarvan?
I mean, everyone takes things out of movies. I didn't put anything into the film that was inherently about bodies of water or water. This has happened to me before, actually, because my first film has a lot of water references as well, and Skoonheid also has 2 or 3 major water references. Maybe it's something subliminal that I don't know about that I put in my films. My previous film was called The Endless River, which is also a body of water. But I think I always find it interesting when people find meaning in things that inherently you haven't actually put there, but that's the great thing about making a film, is that it allows people to have their own interpretations.
Jou hoofkarakter in die rolprent, was daar elemente daarmee met sy karakter wat jy self mee kon identifiseer? En wat is dit aan hom wat jy dink gehore mee sal vereenselwig?
I mean, audiences are different. In South Africa, the audience here is an audience that either lived through this, as in terms of they were conscripts, and their takeaway would either be about their military experience. If there are gay men who go and see this film, they're going to take something very specifically about the emotional journey of this character. If you're a black person who goes and sees this film, you're going to take something entirely different as well. So there's never one coherent audience. We assume that as Africans, the audience is so varied. You just hope that collectively, this is an experience that allows them to have more understanding of South Africa's history.
In jou navorsing vir die rolprent, het jy met baie mense gepraat wat wel soortgelyke ervarings in die oorlog of in die weermag gehad het?
Yes, so obviously this kind of film you can research quite easily because so many people that you work with were in the army. Like a lot of people on our team were in the army. So you have different levels of research. You have conversations with people who you know. You have official conversations with strangers. You have military advisors. You read books. You look at photographs. You watch propaganda films. You watch films from the 80s and the 70s. I watch some of Daryl Roert's films. I fill my head with information and people's emotional kind of reactions, and then that's kind of what I draw from.
So het jy inspirasie geput uit Westiek en Roert se rolprente?
Yeah, because you're looking at how these stories have been told in the past and who have they been told for and what is their political, particularly their political attitude. A lot of the films you're referring to in the 70s and the 80s were politically safe. They were not critical. They were not questioning why this army existed and what this army was doing and what was this fight about and why these men were being killed and why they were killing other people. Morphe might well be the first African film about this war and this time that is actually being quite critical and quite harsh about the experiences of these men.
Jy het in jou eerste antwoord gepraat van die internasionale ambities wat jy het met die rolprent. Waar wil jy graag hê met hierdie rolprent heen gaan?
I mean, it's kind of already happened. Morphe has already been sold to more than a dozen territories, including South Africa. So ultimately, its biggest audience is overseas. And it's amazing when you, obviously, as a filmmaker, you want to make work that gets seen by the biggest audience. And ultimately, work that also gets seen by different kinds of audiences. I'm very lucky that when I make a film, I don't just show my films in South Africa. And I don't just show them at film festivals. They get sold and people go to the movies in different parts of the world and watch my films, as we do here. So I think I've been very fortunate with this film that it's been doing so well, where it's coming out in theaters and actual cinemas for those foreign countries to go and see it. So you feel like you're part of an international film business.
Laastens, is daar iets wat jy vir die gehoor wat nou hierdie bioscoop episode kyk sal wil vertel van jou rolprent?
I mean, I think the thing important to know for South Africans is that Morphe is a provocation, it's a proposition, it's asking us to consider something. And I think that for my intention as a filmmaker is to grow the South African audience's palate and appetite for different kinds of movies and to have a more kind of introspective journey when they watch films. My ask to the audience is to give it a chance and to allow it to kind of live inside of them.
Ek is Annemarie Jansen van Vieren, saam met Oliver Hermanus, hier by die Woordfeest Drostdyteater. Gaan kyk Morphe en vorm jou eie opinie.